Because I talked about memory, I talked about isolation, transferring control from user to OS part of the system that we have, memory where OS code and data structure is. We want to sort of dig deeper into it and really think about how do we define what data and code a certain process or application can access. I said one of the jobs the operating system has is give you high-level abstractions. Okay, so we don't talk about particular memory locations that we happen to have right now, but each process, we said, sort of can believe as if it has the whole computer to itself. In particular, each process wants to feel that it has the memory that it needs, where its data and code is going to go, has to itself. And actually, each process does have something of that sort for itself, and that's called an address space. Address space is sort of a container. It's a sequence of memory locations. Okay? It's a collection, which is a sequence of memory locations that define, a collection of those memory locations defines a space, and each of these locations can be addressed, so that's what makes it an address space. Okay, so each process has the abstraction of memory that is an address space, and address space actually is going to be a unit of isolation. So when we talked about isolation, now we're talking about sort of isolate what from what else, and we're going to talk about isolating address space. Address space completely defines the data and code that is there for a given application. The data and code is going to reside in a bunch of memory locations, and those memory locations together make up an address space that belongs to a particular process or application. So that's why we have to sort of, when we talk about isolation, we had to dig deeper a little bit and think about address spaces. So if a process is essentially going to think that it has the memory to itself, it's going to think of this memory as a contiguous set of locations going from some starting address 0 to some max. And it's going to think that it has this set of memory locations, not only that are contiguous, but they could even be more than the total memory that we have, physical memory that we have in a computer. If you've done your operating systems class, you heard about virtual memory. Most modern operating systems actually support virtual memory. That could be more than the physical memory that we have. So address space that we're talking about for a process is a contiguous container of memory, okay, that can be addressed, which is going from 0 to some maximum address that we can have. And it doesn't have to be constrained by the physical amount of physical memory that we have. So the address space actually, usually if it's a 32-bit architecture, basically means addresses in that case are 32-bit long, or it could be a 64-bit architecture. In that case, they'll be 64-bit long. They go typically from 0 through 2 to the 32 minus 1 or 2 to the 64 minus 1. Your address is n number of bits, and based on that, you can have 2 to the n different locations that you can address with that size of an address. We said the address space is a container for anything that has to be stored in memory for a process. Remember, a process has to fetch instruction data, so that information has to be in memory before it can execute it. Okay, so we have to prepare an address space for a process before it starts execution, and we tell the process, here is an address space for you. You can address the location 0 through something, and you decide to put your data and code in these locations.